Noah.
Hi, Noah. Wow, good morning, guys. You're on fire. Happy Friday.
Hey, good,
yeah.
Man.
Yeah.
Yeah. Aren't you glad that it's Friday?
How was your Halloween, man?
Oh, my gosh. I've done gained pounds. I've done 8 Smarties. I've done 8 Nugs. I've done 8 Kit Kat. Oh, my gosh. And they're not paying me for that. Oh, my gosh.
Oh, my God.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Well, hey.
Yeah. I feel like a fat pig. No, I'm just kidding. I'm kidding.
Well, we can't
no,
see
No, I'm
you,
really
so
happy
I'm
to
sure
be here with you guys this morning. It was a lot of fun. I didn't do no dinging or no donging. So, you know, no one came. I'm like, now, you know, I'm not doing you know, I'm going to sit and relax and watch Hocus Pocus with my bowl of candy. You
there
know?
You go. Mm. Enjoy yourself.
How about you guys? Did you guys have a fun Halloween?
I was actually at the Clippers game last night. That was my Halloween.
Oh. Yeah. I watched The Little Mermaid.
Hey.
Oh, yeah, that's right.
It had been a minute, so I was like, I might as well watch it again, you know, see what's happening. Yeah.
So I was slacking off at the game, and he was researching.
I was doing some serious research.
Yeah. Well, you guys... Oh, sounds wonderful. Let's go ahead and talk about it. So, you know, I love saying these words because, I don't know, it makes me feel like the holidays, well, I mean, they're right upon us. The Wonderful World of Disney presents Little Mermaid Live. It will honor the 30th anniversary. The 30th anniversary, can you believe that? Of the beloved animated classic through a never-before-seen hybrid format that will take viewers on a magical adventure under the sea. So how does it mean to you both to be part of a classical Disney tale that forever lives on? Let's start off with you, Shaggy.
Oh, I'm ecstatic, man. It, you know, this gives me an opportunity to be in my daughter's cool book.
That's right. Yes.
Yeah. Hey, I got 3 daughters, and they've never been excited about anything I've done. Not a song I've written, but this one, I'm kind of looking like the coolest dad on earth right now. It's great, man. You know, to play Sebastian. Sebastian had kind of a Caribbean... flair to him, and me being from Jamaica, it gave me the opportunity to basically go in there and really put my spin to it, put my little touch, my taste, especially with my vocals, you know, my distinctive sound that I have, and really, you know, bring that Jamaicanness and that Caribbeanness to the character and to the vocals.
Yeah, absolutely. How about for you, Graham? How does it feel to be part of something that is so beloved by so many in the Disney world?
Well, like Shaggy, you know, I'm living up to my 8-year-old niece Stella's expectations. She's not entirely sold that I can pull the whole prince thing off yet. I told her, and she was just kind of confused.
She's like, "You're not a prince; you're an uncle."
Yeah, totally. she's not, you know, she's not as about it as I thought. But she's gonna be in the live audience. I'm sure I can flip her and, you know, turn her into a fan by the end of it.
Yeah.
But I
wait until she watches.
I know
she's gonna
love
it.
I'm a little nervous.
Oh, don't be nervous. You guys are gonna kill it. I'm telling you. But I mean, it is live, so you never know what happens when it's live. But I mean,
pros,
I've seen these live musicals before happen, and they are just so beautifully done. And I know you guys are gonna do such a swell job. And as this is a live musical, how has the rehearsals and prepping for the upcoming event? How has that really been like for you both?
It's been good. We've been doing it for the last month, I think. But what was really interesting to me is that when I went in there for the first rehearsal, I think within the first 4 hours, we kind of got it down. And I mean, and it just dawned on me at that point, wow, we're really dealing with some really, really professional people here. The choreography, just how they, you know, walked you through the whole thing. You know, by the first rehearsal, we, you know, I had it pretty much done, and I think Graham had the same experience.
Yeah, they make it pretty idiot proof. I mean, these people, they know what they're doing. They get you on the fast track, you learn it immediately. Yeah. And at first, I was like, only a month of rehearsal. I was like, is that enough? And then by the first, you know, day, I was like, what the heck are we gonna do with all this rehearsal? But it was cool. I mean, we went in and you know, they made it easy on us, but like the chorus and the ensemble and all the aerial dancers, they've been working at it a lot longer. So we walked in and like the number was done.
Yeah.
So we got to watch it before we got plugged in. That was really cool.
Well, I can't wait to check it out. You know, let's kind of touch on your characters and let's kind of tell our audience a little bit about what they'll get to see happening on ABC next week. Now, you know, Shaggy, like you said, you play Sebastian. Graham, you know, your character is Prince Eric. But talk to us a little bit about the premise of the live musical and really what audiences will get to see versus from the animated tale that we, you know, all watched millions of times on Disney.
Well, the plot within itself will be within the animation part of it.
Uh-huh.
But the musical numbers is what's going to be the excitement. You know what I mean? You're talking about a set that is designed so beautiful that when I looked at it, I was just...
He broke down crying.
Oh, yeah.
I'd never seen a grown man cry like that.
You know, they had to bring a mop and a bucket. It was flooding in there, these tears, man.
He brought the sea.
I brought the sea under the sea. but you're going to see, like, jellyfishes and bubbles and frogs and eels and all of that.
Ooh,
the whole puppeteering thing happening. And it's happening in front of a live audience also. So you're going to be able to play off the audience. Big choreography on them. Great costumes. And, you know, of course... Then it segues back into the original animated film. So, you know, I just think it's going to be really... Put it this way, you won't be bored.
No.
Well, I can't wait to check it out, you guys. Now, my last question for you both, you know, out of everything that you two have been able to do in your careers, would you say this has really been, you know, an outstanding honor for you and one of the best things that you both have really been able to do in your career? As, you know, not everybody can say that they were part of a Disney classic.
No, you're right. But you know what? To my whole career, you know, I've done so many things now that this is something new for me. And it's exciting and it's challenging. And it's just where I feel I'm supposed to be at this time with it. It couldn't have come at a better time. And because I'm also in the frame of mind of it. You know, I think if it came earlier in my career, I probably wouldn't have jumped at it because... You know, I was young, getting into doing music, breaking so many grounds musically, especially within my genre at the time, because I was one of the first to actually break down a lot of the barriers and break and within my genre. So I probably wouldn't have done it at that time. Where I'm at now, it was just mentally the right time for it, you know, and I'm very, very happy. Couldn't have come better.
I love that. How about for you, Graham?
Yeah, you know, it's funny, when I got the call to go in and sing for this, it was it came at a great time for me, too. I mean, I was, you know, this industry isn't always, like, you know, the most, like, positive place to be, but it just came at a time when I was really looking for something that was celebratory and joyous, and just being around people that are so like-minded and wanting to, you know, really just have... nothing but bringing joy to other people at mine. Like, it's just been really nice to, you know,
you get to play it. Just be a prince.
Yeah, I also get to be play a prince.
You know me walk around, do you know how many crap jokes I get? You know, I'd rather get prince jokes than crap jokes. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, you try to make a prince joke. You can't even make one.
You can't make a prince joke. It's like, I got prince joke for you. You're cute.
Too. I have to say, this is the best interview for Friday. I'm telling you, you got my whole Friday hyped up. That's right, Shaggy and Graham.
Well, thank you both.
Yeah, thank you both so much for taking the time to chat with me. The Little Mermaid Live, it airs live on Tuesday, November the 5th at 8 p.m. Eastern Standard Time, only on ABC. Thank you, Shaggy and Graham. You guys take care. Have a lovely weekend. And I'm going to go eat more candy.
Hey.
Love it.
Enjoy.
All right. Bye, guys.
Bye-bye.
See ya.